Good morning children. In this video I will explain about you chapter 2 and the topic is structure of chromosome. Children, I have already explained you in my last video about the nucleus, which is also called the control center of the cell. Nucleus contain most of the cell DNA, which is organized into a separate unit or a small unit, that is called chromosomes. Now in this video we will study about what are chromosomes, who discovered the chromosome, what are the structure and what are the functions of chromosome. Basically, chromosomes are the carriers of heredity. It pass on from one generation to another generation. As you can see in the second point in this slide, chrome means colored and soma means body. So in short we can say that chromosomes are colored bodies. These are very small, but they are thick and rod like and they are darkly stainable structures. These are seen in the nuclei of dividing cells only at metaphase and anaphase, stage of cell division, whereas in non-dividing cells they are seen as a network of thread-like structure called chromatin reticulum. Now who discovered the cells? So chromosomes were first discovered by Hofmeister in 1848. He noticed them in the rapidly dividing cells of transcendentia and called them nuclear filament. In 1882, Walther Flaming, a German scientist, was first to study chromosome in animals named salamander, which is an amphibian. In 1888, Waldeyer gave the name chromosome to these nuclear filament, which is discovered by Hofmeister. Now what is chromosome number? So the number of chromosome is always remains constant in the cells of each species. As you know, there are several species in the world and all contain different number of chromosomes. As you can see in this picture, I am showing you here different types of species and their total number of chromosomes. So in the seventh place you can see man is written. So human contain total 46 number of chromosome and the pair is 23, same as frog contains total 26 chromosome. So different plant species and animal species total number of chromosome I am showing in this table. Based on this, chromosome number is divided into two category, haploid and diploid, depending upon the number of chromosomes. Cells are said to be haploid or diploid. So what is haploid cell and what is diploid cell? So a cell is said to be haploid when all the types of chromosome found in it are present in a single set. Haploid cells contain a single set of chromosome, whereas diploid cell contains two set of chromosome. So blood cells, muscle cells, skin cells, all are haploid cells. They contain haploid cells, whereas gametes, that they are like reproductive cells, they are haploid one. And blood cells, muscle cells and skin cells are diploid one. Always remember that male bees, wasps, ant are haploid organism and mammals are diploid organism. Now you can see this picture. It is showing condensation of chromosome. Condensation of chromatin fibers into chromosome during mitotic prophase. So during the prophase, which is one stage of cell division, new chromatin fibers are arranged in the or present in the high thread like structure, highly coiled and condensed. But during metaphase, they convert into chromatids, X like you can see in the third picture. Now, what is chromatin? The chromatin material is composed of two substances, DNA. The full form of DNA is deoxyribonucleic acid and histone protein, which is 60%. So this 40% and 60% together, it will form our eukaryotic chromosome, that is also called as nucleosome. Now, what happened? During metaphase, each chromosome consists of two exactly similar rods. Like you can see here, similar rods consist of two exactly similar rods. These rods are called chromatids. The two chromatids are joined together at a point and it is called centromere. You can see in the picture also, this circle, center circle is called centromere, which connects the chromatin. Chromatid is present in the pairs. They are also called as sister chromatid. Now, parts of these chromatids on the two sides of centromere are called arms. So, you can see short arm also and long arm. So, the chromosome consists of, again, you should know that the chromosome consists of 40% DNA and about 60% of histone protein. Now, what is histone? So, the histone is a protein. Now, the histone and DNA form a kind of complex in which the DNA strands wind around a core of 8 histone molecules, which is a protein. Each form a complex which is called nucleosome. And you should know, children, that a single human chromosome may have about 1 million of nucleosome. Now, in this next slide, I am showing you molecular structure of DNA. What is DNA? So, DNA is present in the linear sequence on the chromosome. So, the shape of DNA molecule was first studied by Rosalind Franklin in 1953. But the final structure worked by Watson and Crick. Remember, in the same year, Watson and Crick, in the 1953 only, Watson and Crick explained the structure of the detailed structure of the DNA, and they proposed this double helical structure. You can see on the screen, double helical structure of DNA, and they awarded Nobel Prize for proposing the double helical structure of DNA in 1962. According to them, a single DNA molecule is very large and hence it is described as a macromolecule. You can see in the picture, there are two long and parallel strands or chains helically coiled around the same axis is given, which appear like a spiral staircase. So, each single DNA strand is composed of repeating nucleotide, which are made up of three components. First one is phosphate, sugar is pentose, and it is arranged lengthwise, and a nitrogenous base is attached to the sugar inverts, which is joined by hydrogen bond. So, this red and blue strands are basically made up of phosphate and sugar. And in between, you can see G, C, A and T. These are nitrogenous bases. Now, there are four types of nitrogenous bases. First one is adenine, which is denoted by capital A. Guanine, which is denoted by capital G, cytosine, which is denoted by capital C, thymine, which is denoted by capital T. Now, always remember, as you can see in this picture also, that guanine is complementary to cytosine and thymine is complementary to adenine. So, you can see in this picture, guanine is attached with 3 hydrogen bond with cytosine, and thymine pairs with 2 hydrogen bond with adenine. They are complementary to each other. Now, what are histones? As I told you, histones are the protein that helps in the coiling and packaging of DNA into structural unit called nucleosome. So, what is nucleosome? DNA plus histone, 8 histone protein makes up nucleosome. Now, I have already explained you that, and label diagram I am showing you here, that it consists of a two sister chromatid always present in the pairs, that is joined at a point, and that point is called centromere. Now, what are genes? Genes are specific sequences of nucleotide on a chromosome that encode particular protein which express in the form of some particular feature of the body. For example, there is a different gene which shows sequence of our hair, for our finger, for our different organs. There is a specific and unique genes. These are transferred from parents to offspring and are responsible for some specific character. Specific character means our tallness, our skin color, etc. Now, what are the functions of chromosomes? Chromosomes, they form the link between the two generations. Always remember, with the help of chromosome only, they form only link between the two generations. They control the synthesis of structural protein, which help in cell division, cell repair, and cell growth. They also determine the sex of the individual, whether it is male or female. They also determine the process of crossing over, variations, mutations, etc. They also helps in controlling cell metabolism. So chromosome plays a very vital role. Now, this is the end of the slide. In my next class, I will explain you about the cell division, which is the next topic of this class, of this chapter, chapter number 2. Now, please read the chapter at home. Thank you and have a nice day.